everyone. Welcome to MYP Biology. Our topic today is going to be about movement in multicellular organisms. So let's get started. First of all, we're going to start with blood movement. As you know, blood gives the oxygen, essential nutrients to organs and takes their waste materials and excrete from our organisms. It starts from the left ventricle, aorta emerges from left ventricle, takes deoxygenated blood around our body, and then comes back to the right atrium and right ventricle. And from right ventricle, the pulmonary artery goes out from heart to our lungs and gets the oxygen and gives the carbon dioxide. So this is how blood is actually moving around our body. Muscle cells are moving blood through the heart. Guys, our heart is made of cardiac muscle, and cardiac muscle only exists in the heart. Cardiac muscle contains cardiac muscle cells, which perform highly coordinated actions that keep the heart pumping and blood circulating throughout the body. Unlike our skeletal muscle tissue, the movements of the cardiac muscle tissue produce involuntarily, so we cannot voluntarily beat our heart. It beats involuntarily. Cardiac muscle tissue, are called myocardium, is a specialized type of muscle, and that is only exist in the heart. And this is it contracts and releases involuntarily, so responsible for the keeping heart pumping blood around the body. As you see, the cardiac muscle is on the right in front of the here, so you can see how the cardiac muscles actually look like. Movement of blood through the arteries and veins. As you know, carrying blood around the body is really important, and so for carrying blood from the heart and to the heart, the arteries, veins, and capillaries play an important role. You know that the arteries are the blood vessels that carry the oxygenated blood away from the heart. And with the veins, on the other hand, are the opposite arteries, that they carry the deoxygenated blood back to the heart. Actually, they look like they share the same composition, but as you know, pressure in arteries is much more than in veins. And veins has, in some veins, there are actually walls that make sure that the flow of the blood travels to the heart, not backwards. Because the pulse can be obtained in arteries because of the high blood pressure, but in veins, we cannot just obtain the pulse. When it comes to capillaries, are the smallest part of the blood vessels, and they operate as a link between arteries and veins, where the exchange of blood and tissue takes place in capillary bed. As you see, the arteries and veins, how they look like in the picture. Movement of skeletal muscles. So guys, skeletal muscles are the muscles that we voluntarily can move our skeletal muscles. And in many cases, the skeletal muscles contraction maintains body position. For example, holding your head while watching this lesson is also, using your skeletal muscles. Each skeletal muscle consists of hundreds or even thousands of skeletal muscle fibers. They are wrapped and bundled together, as you see here, and in a connective tissue which supports and protects the delicate muscles and also provides pathway for nerves and blood vessels to reach the muscles. The skeletal muscles also need a rich blood supply to provide them with nutrients and oxygen also to function. So muscle movement and ventilation, it's really important. And as you know, while we are breathing in and breathing out, we use our muscles. So Here, when we're breathing, there are actually two bands of the muscles that our ribs are actually covered. These are the external intercostal and internal intercostal muscles, and also diaphragm take the action. When muscles are in a relaxed inhalation, when we're in a relaxed state, and when we're breathing, what happens? The external intercostal muscles contract and expand, giving the lungs a bigger room. And while the diaphragm actually goes down and creates a cavity for the lungs to expand, while in exhalation, the internal intercostal muscles contract and shrink, and diaphragm goes up and, removing the cavity for the lungs and letting lungs to come back to its own state. Movement in alveolars. As you know, while the air passing through the trachea, bronchs, and bronchioles, at the end of the bronchioles, we have the alveoli. They are covered and enclosed with capillaries where the diffusion of gas actually happening. So in here, as you see, the carbon dioxides are getting into alveoli. By this way, it's going out. The oxygen gets into blood through the alveoli and blood vessel membranes. Air pollution impact on gas exchange. Today we're going to also talk about the certain problem that air pollution cause. One of them is like actually the asthma is an obstructive lung disease. Basically, it's hard for the airflow, like air, to get out of the lungs rather than getting into that one. Also, air pollution takes a really important role here, causing a lot of respiratory disease. One of them is like it could be the asthma, where the inflammation of the mucus, there's a lot of mucus and inflammation of the certain membranes are swelling, that it doesn't let the air to get out. So here, in the person with asthma, the lungs expand normally and the air usually has no problem traveling into lungs. The problem starts because the air cannot get out through narrowed airways, and this causes the asthma attacks, which is really serious. So here, guys, you have got database question, the impact of exposure to traffic on indicators of the asthma. So here, there's the Hyde Park in Oxford Street. The Hyde Park is just park with full of trees, and Oxford is actually the place where there is a lot of traffic. Like before sitting and being here, what's your pH level? And then after 3-6, or within 3-6 hours, what happens to your pH level in your body? And also here, just myeloperoxidase days, what happens to myeloperoxidase? Do you know that it's very harmful thing for our body and our lungs? So what happens it in Hyde Park is less, in Oxford Street are. So this is going to be your assignment. You're going to talk about and discuss what we see in the graph. So here we have the review questions. That's how blood moves around the body. Talk about heart muscles, pressure in arteries and veins, function of skeletal muscles, movement in respiratory organs, gas exchange, and asthma. If you cannot answer one of the questions, go back and review the lesson again. So try to answer all the questions here. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a nice day. Bye bye.